Where's pot pan that he helps not to take away? He shift a trencher, he escape a trencher.
One good manner shall lie in one or two men's hands, and they unwashed too. Tis a foul thing.
Away with the joint stools, remove the court cupboard, look to the plate. Good thou, save me a piece of march pane, and as thou lovest me, let the porter let in Susan Grindstone and Nell, Anthony and pot pan.
Aye, boy, ready.
Yep.
You are looked for and called for, asked for and sought for, in the great chamber.
We cannot be there and there too. Cheerly, boys, be brisk a while, and not the longer liver take all.
Welcome, gentlemen. Ladies that have their toes unplagued with corns will have a bout with you. Aha, my mistress. Which of you all will now deny to dance? She that makes dainty, she, I'll swear, hath corns. Am I come near ye now? Welcome, gentlemen. I have seen the day that I have worn a visor and could tell a whispering tale in a fair lady's ear. Such as would please. Tis gone, tis gone, tis gone. You are welcome, gentlemen. Come, musicians. Play a hall, a hall. Give room and foot it, girls. More light, you knaves, and turn the tables up and quench the fire. The room is grown too hot. Ah, sirrah, this unlooked for sport comes well. Nay, sir, nay, sit, good cousin Capulet, for you and I are past our dancing days. How long is it now since last yourself and I were in a mask?
By our lady, 30 years.
What man? Tis not so much, tis not so much. Tis since the nuptial of Lucentio. Come Pentecost, as quickly as it will. Some 25 years, and then we masked.
More tis more. His son is elder, sir, by 30 years.
Will you tell me that? His son was but a ward 2 years ago.
Oh, she doth teach the torches to burn bright. It seems she hangs upon the cheek of night, like a rich jewel in an Ethiop's ear. Beauty too rich for use, for earth too dear. So shows a snowy dove, trooping with crows, as yonder lady over her fellows shows. The measure done, I'll watch her place of stand, and touching hers, make blessed my rude hand. Did my heart love till now? Forswear it, sight, for I never saw true beauty till this night.
This, by his voice, should be a Montague. Fetch me my raper, boy. What dares the slave? Come hither, covered with an antic face, to fleer and scorn our solemnity? Now, by the stock and honor of my kin, to strike him dead, I hold it not a sin.
Why how now, kinsman? Wherefore storm you so?
Uncle, this is a Montague, our foe, a villain, that is hither come in spite, to scorn our solemnity this night.
Young Romeo, is it?
'Tis he, that villain Romeo.
Content thee, gentle cuz. I let him alone. He bears him like a portly gentleman, and, to say truth, Verona brags of him. To be a virtuous and well-governed youth, I would not for the wealth of all this town therefore be patient. Take no note of him. It is my will, the which, if thou respect, show a fair presence and pull off these frowns. An ill beseeming semblance for a feast. He shall be endured! What good man, boy? I say he shall. Go to! Am I the master around here, or you? Go to! You'll not endure him? God shall mend my soul. You'll make a mutiny among my guests. You will set cock a hoop. You'll be the man.
Why, uncle, 'tis a shame!
Go to, go to! You are a saucy boy, is it so? Indeed. The trick may chance to scathe you. I know what you must contrary me. You are princox. Go, be quiet, or more light. For shame, I'll make you quiet. What? Cheerily, my hearts.
Patience, perforce, with a willful caller meeting, makes my flesh tremble with different greeting. I will withdraw, but with intrusion shall. Now, seeming sweet, convert to this bitterest gall.
If I profane with my unworthiest hand this holy shrine, the gentle fine is this. My lips, two blushing pilgrims, stand, ready stand, to smooth that rough touch with a tender kiss.
Good pilgrim, you do wrong your hand too much, which mannerly devotion shows in this. For saints have hands that pilgrim's hand do touch, and palm to palm is holy palmer's kiss.
Have not saints lips and holy palmers too?
Aye, pilgrim, lips that they must use in prayer.
Oh then, dear saint, let lips do what hands do. They pray, grant thou, as fate turn to despair.
Saints do not move, though grant for prayer's sake.
Then move not, while my prayer's effect I take. Thus from my lips, by thine my sin is purged.
Then have my lips the sin that they have took.
Lips, O trespass, sweetly urged, give me my sin again.
You kiss by the book.
Madam, your mother craves a word with you.
Okay!
What is your mother?
Mary, bachelor. Her mother is the lady of the house, and a good lady, a wise and virtuous. I nursed her daughter that you talked withal. I tell you, he that can lay hold of her shall have the chinks.
Is she a Capulet? Oh, dear count, my life is at my foe's debt. Away, be gone, the sport is at the best! Aye, so I fear, the more is my unrest.
Nay, gentlemen, prepare not to be gone. We have a rifling foolish banquet towards. Is it e'en so? Why then, I thank you, honest gentlemen, good night. More torches here! Come on, then, let's go. Let's to bed, ah, sirrah. By my fay, it waxes late, all to my rest.
Come hither, nurse. What is yon gentleman?
The son and heir of Tiberio.
Cut.
What's he that now of going out of door?
Marry that, I think, be young Petruchio.
What's he that follows there that could not dance?
I know not.
Go ask his name, and if he be married, my grave is like to be my wedding bed.
His name is Romeo. A Montague, a son of your great enemy.
My only love, sprung from my only hate, too early seen unknown, and known too late. Prodigious birth of love, it is to me that I must love a loath enemy.
Oh.
What's this?
A rhyme I learned even now of one with dance withal.
Anon, anon, come, let's away. The strangers are all gone.
Hi there, I'm Philip Ryan, the director of this film. I'm here to talk to you today about some general parenting ideas. As with many families today, you could say that Tybalt and Father Capulet didn't exactly get along all too well. Nevertheless, Father Capulet serves as a father figure for Tybalt and demonstrates effective parenting techniques that parents of this day and age can learn from. He maintains a strong hold on his nephew's life. Thanks to his uncle, Tybalt did not kill Romeo that night. But do take note of Tybalt's aggressive behavior later on in the story, which proved to be a downfall for both families. Thank you.
Gently breathe.